So far, we've focused most of our attention on tulips in the landscape, seeing them as acres and acres of colorful eye candy. I'd like to switch gears a bit here and turn our attention to the single tulip flower, just one. I find that this flower, more than any other flower, holds up to the scrupulous eye of a demanding illustrator or a picky photographer. There's no surprise about that, given that with its simple form, its elegant beauty, dazzling array of colors, and endless variation, no surprise that this is a favorite subject of many visual artists. It's also a subject that's very capable of imparting its extravagance and infectious enthusiasm upon the onlooker. In fact, entire societies and history is full of people who have been taken over by this captivating, alluring power of tulips. For example, as I'm sure you all remember from your fourth grade history class, in 1731, a Turkish sultan was actually dethroned for having squandered way too much national treasure on lavish tulip displays. And it doesn't stop there. In fact, the world's first economic bubble and attendant rising overnight riches and your overnight losses as well, it was based on tulip bulb trade, and it occurred in Holland in the early 17th century. Actually, the name for this speculative trading frenzy based on the tulip bulb is referred to as tulipomania. And during the height of the frenzy, a single bulb, a single flower and bulb such as the Viceroy, could fetch as much as $250,000 in today's dollars. And yeah, unbelievable, huh? But it doesn't stop there. The most expensive one, the rarest and most prized tulip, was the Semper Augustus. And it went at its highest price in today's dollars for one, just one tulip and bulb, somewhere between $2 and $3 million. Today's, yeah. It's crazy, yeah. It's like they say, sometimes fact is stranger than fiction. So with all this history behind this flower, I think it would be fitting to take a portrait. Like, do a portrait of the single tulip flower that'll do it justice. I figure it's a classic flower, and it deserves a classic photo technique. And what could be more classic than that glamorous black and white photography from the golden era of Hollywood? That style was popularized by photographers such as George Harrell, and the style is defined by elegant posing and dramatic light and harsh shadows. Today's cameras, they're based on electronic flash, and it only exists for a short duration, illuminating your subject. Whereas with a continuous flash, we'll be using a flashlight, as you can actually look at the subject and see how it'll look, because with a strobe, it's only illuminated boop, for that brief 10,000ths of a second when the strobe fires. Finding the perfect specimen, one gem jewel box single tulip flower. So let's go find that tulip. Think I could find one out here? See any? There's gotta be one, just one exquisite, perfect one. For my glamorous portrait tulip here, I want to restrict the light. I'm going to be providing the light with a flashlight, but I only want it to fall on one single tulip and not get splattered around on other flowers or the background. So in order to do that, I'm going to make myself what's called a snoot. Now what it means is more like a cone, a restriction of the cone. It reduces the spread of light. And this is actually official cinematic aluminum foil. Slightly different than Reynolds wrap, I guess. And I've got a quickly fashioned, make do in the field, no extension cords necessary, a gelled, snooted continuous light. And see how it's only hitting one beautiful red and carmine yellow, nice tulip. So I still need to wait a little bit for the ambient light levels to drop here. There's still a little too much daylight, because I need to have it almost as dark as night in order to provide, to have the lighting effect stand out and have that dazzling, elegant black and white photo from the golden era of Hollywood. So I'm just gonna literally play around here, move it. Do I want it from underneath? Look at it from the side. And another thing that photographers did in this day using this style of black and white photography is that they would often mix the angles of light sources. We don't do that these days. We try to keep it to one direction of the light. But back then, that just wasn't part of the style. You could really have light coming from two different directions. That would help create harsh and interesting shadows. And try the light from a lower angle now. And, oh, we're getting there. Finally, I'm seeing a little bit of improvement. Okay, at this point, I should time my exposures for brief lulls in the breeze. Because at a half second, even the slightest movement will cause subject blur. I think that one worked out. More or less. Whether you're a lone wolf photographer in search of the perfect photograph, or looking to send a JPEG from your camera phone to all of your buddies, the Wooden Shoe Tulip Festival is the place to be, and it delivers in a big way each and every year. As we've seen, this festival, there's much more to it than just photography. It's also a place where great and lasting memories can be made. From the tulip fields and pony rides, to the craft market and beer and wine garden, there's something here for everyone. For more information about the festival and also about this episode and related post-processing tutorials, please visit OregonPhotoAdventure.com. And until next time, plant tulips and multiply.